13 kids from all over the United States and Canada gathered for a summer genetics and genealogy camp to find their roots.
I wanted to learn more about my ancestry and where I'm actually from.
We're pretty sure that like our mom's side of the family is German.
My mom's mother is from Jamaica and my dad's mother is from Jamaica.
My great-great-grandparents came from India.
I believe we are from European descent.
Weeks before camp began, they all submitted DNA for testing to look deep into their family's genetic history. They will each open their individual results at the same time together.
Three, two, one.
Click on it.
Now, early on, we actually looked and saw, at least to some degree, the way DNA actually looks. Now we get to dig in on actually what it says. What does it say? What does it say?
DNA is just, oh my God, it's just the, it's the gift that keeps on giving. Remember, you have 8 great-grandparents, 16 great-great-grandparents, 32 third-great-grandparents, and 64 fourth-great-grandparents. There are a lot of stories buried on that family tree. You inherit DNA from these people. Back 6 generations, you inherit some DNA from all of them.
So what we'll do now is let's focus on this exercise here. So based on the conversation we had, based on these categories, right, let's guess. Draw a pie chart here of what you think. What's your guess about what you might be?
It's interesting to see kids make sense of what they believe to be true. And just because a person is born in a place doesn't mean that that's where their genes have migrated from. On that notion of like, but I was always told that he was from here. And so making sense of that can be challenging for some people.
Because my ancestors originated from India, I think I'm gonna be 25% Indian. And then since my parents are from Guyana, I think 25% Guyanese.
I really understand and really, really like Native Americans' cultures. And I thought North Africa because I like their cultures too.
But what do you think you are? Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years ago, right? There was a slave trade. And people from Sub-Saharan Africa were brought to the New World as slaves.
So right? They took from here?
That's right.
Not here?
No.
Well, I think I'm East Asian because I only have information about that since I'm adopted.
That's what I think, yeah. Because that's the only information I've ever gotten that I'm from China.
All of my family traveled over from Europe at one time.
My prediction that I was gonna have a little bit of European because my father told me a story that about his grandmother and the great grandmother of the grandmother told the grandmother that her grandmother was European. So the European ones in the family, that's what I know.
I think I am 90% European, and I put 10% for other because who knows what.
I think I am 60% Sub-Saharan African, 20% Native American, and 20% European.
I think I'm 99.9% European and 0.1% other.
I think I'm 80% European, 5% Middle Eastern, and 15% other.
I'm gonna be super shocked if I'm like Spanish or something.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Open it up.
Yep.
The day that we had the kids open their DNA ancestry accounts and look at the results, they were glued. There was nothing more exciting to them than reading about their own unique genetic information.
Oh my gosh. Oh,
I'm 100% European.
Whoa.
I knew it.
And I'm mostly sub-Saharan African. I'm part Egyptian, or not Egyptian, European. I'm part East Asian and North Native American.
90.1 Chinese, 0.2% Korean,
cool.
0.7% broadly East Asian, 0.8.
So this is basically mostly Asian.
I'm British and Irish, French and German, Scandinavian. I'm 22.9% German. That seems about right because my mom.
You're 55.7% European. And you're 55.7%.
How much are you British and Irish?
I'm more British and Irish.
I'm 37.4 British and Irish.
37.6.
Can I say
one more time? Since we're twins, I thought we would have the same makeup of DNA and ancestry, but we didn't.
It wasn't the same. Right? Despite the fact that you are?
Twins.
Isn't biology amazing?
Yes.
Twins.
We're not identical twins, we're fraternal twins.
Oh, so maybe that has something to do with it.
Yeah.
You have maps. We are the product of an interesting route, right? People came from different places. Trace their routes and the places they lived on that map, okay?
I'm Egyptian.
My mom's ancestors basically came from here to here.
So you have some of the coolest things I've ever seen. They come from really interesting parts of the world, right?
Right, and we'll look in the results, right? And then that's to Jamaica, right? Boom. And then you have Argentina, where's Argentina down here? But that comes from here.
I know which is maternal, but I'm not sure where each came from, but I know they came from like six different countries.
That should look cool. Yep.
Now I have to get my mom's home.
When you feel good about what your routes, we're all going to draw on with a dry erase marker on this board.
Excellent. Powerful. I mean, look at that map.
I saw there's a lot of West African genes in this room. Right? This region here. This region here. Now, you may not know the exact country, but we do know this is a region.
The campers' lines of migration converged on America from every corner of the world, revealing many different paths. After camp, Jordan did further research to confirm his father's story and make more sense of his family tree.
My great-grandmother, Louise Williams, was from Calcutta, India. So I found out that I'm Indian, partially Indian. This side of the family is Scottish, which is kind of cool.
And the test introduced Jenna to relatives she didn't know she had.
And just recently I had found out that I had 125 DNA relatives, and we've been trying to contact some of them.
Looks like that's where they are.
Oh, that's so cool.
So it says you're 20.
But for all the shocks and surprises, Christopher knew one thing had not changed.
I'm 100% Christopher Johnson.
You're 100% Christopher Johnson. And you know what? That might be the most important piece of data there is. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Kids love to study themselves. We can show you how you can bring the tools of finding your roots into your after-school program, summer camp, or classroom. Check out what happens when kids study their own DNA and family history by viewing our education programs and trying our research-based curriculum materials. For more information, visit us online.
Major support for Finding Your Roots, The Seedlings, has been provided by the Benkovic Family Foundation, with additional support from WETA, Public Television for Greater Washington, the Hutchins Center for African and African American Research at Harvard, and the following.
Mm-hmm.